We tend to think that museums are kind of keeping the extraordinary, and that the extraordinary is the opposite to the ordinary. That what happens in the rooms is really something that is isolated, and that the museum is actually producing this isolation. I think it's not like that. I think that it's totally different, but the fact that there are so many things that are hidden in museums make that wrong impression. What we've been doing is studying all those hidden spaces, places like the carpentry workshop, or the place where the photographer takes the photographs for the catalogs, posters, postcards, or the place where the cleaning ladies get changed and where they have the lockers, or the place where the mail arrives and is distributed from, or the place where the people that are lifting and carrying things from one place to another are having their office, their lockers, and the social space. Or, for instance, the places that are materially sustaining the discussions that are also part of the rooms that you see here in the visitors' tour, or the places where curators discuss, meet, or host other people, artists, have discussions with galleries. All these things are the processes in which the museum is becoming a society that is formed with by so many people, by so many ideas, by so many plans, by so many objects. And actually, in this particular museum, this is very important, because it's about decoration, it's about objects, it's about the production of ordinary life. And actually, all these things that we could think that are kind of super intellectual and cultural debates are already happening in all these places.
Das hört sich an.